you loud, 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 loud. And you can always tell when a woman wanna play. She got on the major slippers in her apple skirt. And
a mood can't see day.
Night, you held on up, just it fits you right. And
oh, you've been to Kansas City,
so you bought.
Oh, you've been to Kansas City,
so you bought.
And you've been, mama, tell me why they don't lie to you.
Kansas City Blues. As you may have noticed, a jugless Memphis jug band, recording in 1927. Now, there couldn't be much more of a contrast than what's to follow. And it takes us from the rustic folk music roots of jazz to the polished and commercially oriented music of the swing era. This is a band which owes its existence to the readers of the magazine Metronome, who were polled every year to discover the most popular soloists. The results replied somewhat loosely in the makeup of a Victor recording group, the Metronome All-Stars. In 1941, they were Harry James, Ziggy Elman and Cootie Williams trumpet, Tommy Dorsey and J.C. Higginbottom trombone, Benny Goodman clarinet, Toots Mondello and Benny Carter alto, Coleman Hawkins and Tex Beneke tenor, Count Basie piano, Charlie Christian electric guitar, Artie Bernstein bass and Buddy Rich drums. bugle call rag, the metronome all-stars of 1941. Miz Mesereau was one of the most colourful characters in jazz, and he lived a whirlwind existence in the music's most exciting era. In the early 1920s, he heard all the great New Orleans pioneers in Chicago, played in a nightclub owned by Al Capone, fell in with the Austin High Gang, the young jazz-mad teenagers whose friends included Red McKenzie and Eddie Condon, recorded with them in Chicago and New York, made a tour of Europe, and then succumbed to opium addiction, all in the space of just over 10 years. In 1936, after an agonising drug rehabilitation, which is chronicled in his fascinating autobiography, Really the Blues, he began playing again, and one of his first jobs was a recording session for Victor. Here's a sample. Miz Mesereau and his swing band. Frank Newton, trumpet. Miz Mesereau, clarinet. Bud Freeman, tenor. Willie the Lion Smith, piano. Al Casey, guitar. Wellman Bro, bass. And George Stafford, drums. Mutiny in the Parlour. Miz Mesereau with a really biting clarinet tone and his swing band in 1936. A few weeks ago, I spotted a record in a junk shop that really intrigued me. It was by Lizzie Miles on the Capitol label, so obviously of relatively recent vintage. Could this, I wondered, be the same Lizzie Miles who recorded with Jelly Roll Morton in the late 1920s? Sure enough, it is. Recorded in New Orleans in 1952. And the band is equally interesting, led by trumpeter Sharky Bonanno.
My name's naughty dog. Yes, naughty dog. Now I've been east and I've been west, but I like New Orleans the best. It's a salty dog. Yes, a salty dog. But when it comes to loving, I ain't no fool. I'm a salty dog. Yes, a salty dog. Now 16 men in love with me, but the man I love ain't legally free. He's a salty dog. Yes, a salty dog. Say, I believe my man's got a black cat phone, 'cause when I leave, I got to run back home. He's a salty dog. Yes, a salty dog.
Lizzie Miles and Salty Dog, a very short version, but that's exactly as the disc was released on 78 in 1952, including that slow fade-out. Here's Glenn Miller, and I thought it might be interesting to hear something from his big band before he became the idol of the Bobby Soxers in 1939. He formed the band in March 1938, after having had a commercial disaster with a band formed in 1937. On lead clarinet, he hired Wilbur Schwartz, who was destined to play a major role in producing the distinctive Miller Reed sound. Here's how the band sounded in the early stage of its development in May 1938.
Thank you.
King Oliver's Dippermouth Blues from the embryo Glenn Miller Orchestra in 1938. Irving Mills was the most influential man in New York's music scene of the late 1920s. Apart from being a composer, lyricist, music publisher and manager for Duke Ellington and Cab Calloway, he also arranged dozens of recording sessions. The discs came out under such names as Mills Blue Rhythm Band, Mills Merrymakers, and Irving Mills and his Hotsy Totsy Gang. Here's a typical example from 1930. The Hotsy Totsy Gang, comprising Manny Klein and Bill Moore trumpet, Tommy Dorsey trombone, Jimmy Dorsey clarinet, Babe Russin tenor, Jack Cornell piano accordion, Hoagie Carmichael piano and vocal, Joe Tarto brass bass, and Gene Krupa drums.
Boy, that is a reason. I'm high and dry. Got burglaries, fat, and lots of hi-hats. My Bill Book's fat, and boy, tell me, ain't that a reason? I'm high and dry. I've saved up all my money, and no fear of a rainy day. I lost the loving from my honey, chasing the blues away. Well, I'm riding style with a big boy smile. I got the dough to show, and boy, you know the reason. I'm high and dry.
Irving Mills and his Hotsy Totsy Gang, High and Dry, in 1930. Miff Mowell is renowned as a founder member of Phil Napoleon's original Memphis Five, and for his long association with Red Nichols. Together they developed a distinctly New York style of jazz playing, rather more restrained than the Chicago variety. Here's a notable exception, one of Miff Mowell's most lively records. It was made in April 1929, Miff Mowell and his Little Molars. Leo McConville and Manny Klein trumpet, Miff Mowell trombone, Jimmy Dorsey clarinet, Arthur Shutt piano, Eddie Lang guitar and Stan King drums.
Thank you.
Rats Aplenty, Miff Mole and His Little Molars in 1929. The next program in the series will contain equally varied fare. There's more New York jazz from Thomas Morris with Fats Waller, the authentic sound of New Orleans from Jelly Roll Morton, Kansas City jazz from Benny Moten, and West Coast revival jazz from Turk Murphy. And talking of revivalists, here's one of Australia's most influential and widely admired jazzmen of the 40s and 50s, Ade Monsborough. A tower of strength in the original Graham Bell band, he developed into one of the most accomplished and fiery reed men of the post-war trad revival. Here's one of his 1952 recordings with a small group comprising Don Roberts clarinet, Ade Monsborough alto, Graham Bell celeste, Norm Baker banjo, Lucille Bryson bass, and Roger Bell washboard and vocal encouragement. Lazy Ade and his Late Hour Boys, Up to No Good.
His Late Hour Boys getting up to no good, and more toe-tapping vintage jazz from Robert Parker at the same time next week. We've some news to bring to you before our next programme. Over now to David Bellin.
There's been a new development at Larnaca Airport in Cyprus, where the high